A very good morning. Welcome to St. John's. Lovely to see you this bank holiday weekend. And we're in the month of May, so it is really good to see you. Do stay behind afterwards for a cup of tea and coffee. But before anything else, I am just going to read some bands of marriage. Met a lovely couple the other day who are getting married in June. And I'm just going to read their bands of marriage. So I'm publishing the bands of marriage between Thomas Benjamin Galali and Danielle Catherine Ranson, both of this parish. This is for the first time of asking. If anyone knows any reason in law why these persons may not marry each other, you are to declare it. And another thing beginning with B must be birthdays. Has anybody got a birthday in the month of May? We've got Derek. Is that the only one? So, Derek, you can have all of these if you like. If I can open them. There we go. Oh, look. There we go. Okay. To take something for Nathan. Okay. Okay, I'm just looking at your mum to make sure that Nathan will get it. There, that's it. I knew he would, really. There we go. Thank you. And I think what we normally do is we normally sing happy birthday to everyone who's got birthdays in May. So, Mark, if you just bring this up. And we haven't got a band, I'm afraid, this morning. All of the music's going to be piped. So if somebody wants to try and lead us in happy birthday, let's go.
On three. One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. To Jesus be true. God bless you and keep you. Happy birthday to you.
Okay, and just a special welcome as well to people joining us online. And I'm just going to explain why I am in jeans and trainers this morning. I did manage to be Mr. Clumsy on Friday and knock a cup of boiling water over my foot. And there's a blister the size of Lake Michigan on my foot at the moment. So if I'm not so active up here, you'll understand why. But that's why I'm particularly dressing down, including the footwear today. But it's good to meet together in the Lord's presence. Let me say a prayer and we'll sing our first song. Father God, thank you that we can meet and worship you. And we just ask that you lift our hearts now to your throne room as we praise your great name. Amen. Well, please stand. Our first song of Praise is Rising.
Turning to you, we turn to you. Oh,
Fantastic. Well, please do sit down. I'm just going to grab a pen from here. One of the things it's always good to do when we meet together is just think about the ways we can say thank you to God for his goodness to us. So if you just think back over the last week, the last month, and just somebody throw out a couple of ideas of things we can say thank you to God for. What can we say thank you to God for? The weather. Gavin's a guy who likes to get outside. Food on our table. Brilliant, yes. Anything else? Something you must be really thankful for. Oh, try to think. So many. Your life. That's a good thing too. The gift of life. Yep, yep, brilliant. Gift of life. It is a wonderful gift. The gift of life. Anything else? Anyone at the back? Friends and family. A peaceful country. Great. Mark?
Compassion.
Okay. And the other big thing, of course, is we've just celebrated Easter. So let's pray. Okay, let's say thank you to God for these wonderful blessings. Lord God, we thank you that you love us so much. We thank you for the Easter season, knowing that you are risen and our lives will never be the same for the hope that we have. We thank you for your compassion. We thank you for the joy that we can have. And we thank you for all good things, for the wonderful weather we've been enjoying, wonderful food on our tables. We thank you for the gift of life. And how special that is. We thank you for friends, for family, and being able to live in a country of peace. Amen. It's also good to say sorry to God for all the things we get wrong. So Mark's going to bring up a confession prayer. And let's just take a moment of silence as we reflect on the last few days. And we'll say sorry to God for all the things we do wrong. So we pray, dear Lord, for the times we have not obeyed your ways, for the times we have forgotten you, for the times we have hurt and offended others, for the times we have not cared about your world, for the times we have not served you as we should, for all these, please forgive us. And Lord, we do thank you that when we come to you in confession, we know that you are merciful and love to forgive us when we turn back to you. Amen. Well, of course, God loves us to come to him. And he says, here I am. I stand at the door and knock. The Lord Jesus is knocking on the door of our lives, wanting to come in and to bless us in every way. So we're going to sing this action song. And so if you want to stand, we might need a bit more volume on this one, Mark. Do you remember the actions for this? We start off by doing a bit more. We've started. Stand. A bit more volume. More. Come on, Matt, Alfie. Let's go.
Here I
Otherwise, you're marching forever. So, thank you, Mark. Well, I think Rupert's here. Do sit down. Shall I go and see if Rupert's in his normal place in the pulpit, having a little nap? Come on, wake up. Here he is. As you know, Rupert is my dog. He loves to live in his bag. And shall we see if he's there? Yep, there's his nose. He's having a look around. Hello. Hello, Alfie. He's got three objects in his bag today. And they're going to help us to know. They're clues to today's Bible story. So we need to have in, look in, okay, I can see your ego going. So let's see what's your first object you can get. What's that? Handcuffs. So that's the first clue to the story. What in it, some people are chained up. Okay, so that's the first clue. So we'll put these over here. Right, there's a second clue in here. Anybody else? Anybody else want to get into the spirit of it? Alex, do you want to see what's in there? Alex has gone for the money. Well, there we go. So there's another clue. Something about money. Somebody earning lots and lots of money in today's true story from the Bible. And I think we've got one more. What's that? A door. In particular, an open door. A door that was closed and is open. Okay, so there are our three clues. People being chained up, a door that opens, and money. Okay. We're going to hear the true story from the Bible now. We're going to have a little video clip of it. It doesn't have the whole story in detail, but it has most of it. And there might be some questions. So they better pay attention. Okay, well, say goodbye to Rupert. Okay, we'll now have the Bible reading, the Bible story.
Slapstick Theater, Paul and Silas. This is Paul.
Hey!
Who told people about Jesus in lots of different places. One day, Paul was walking with his friend Silas.
Hey, yo!
They were being followed by a girl who was controlled by an evil spirit. Her owners used her to make money. After days and days of this happening, Paul got so annoyed that he turned around and told the evil spirit to leave her. So the girl was free.
Woohoo!
But her owners got mad at Paul and Silas because they wouldn't make any money off of her anymore. And they had them thrown in jail. The jailer locked them up.
Oh, man!
Around midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing to God, and the other prisoners were listening. Suddenly, there was an earthquake and the chains of all the prisoners fell off.
Oh, what just happened?
But Paul and Silas didn't leave, even though they could have. Several people decided to follow Jesus that night, including the jailer and his whole family. And the next morning, they were released from jail, and the city officials even apologized to them.
Sorry about that.
Paul and Silas encouraged the Christians in the town, and they continued on their mission to tell people about Jesus.
See ya!
Wow, fantastic Bible story. We're going to be thinking about that in a little bit more detail, but first of all, we're going to sing again. We're going to sing, We Want to See Jesus Lifted High. It might be a little bit too loud on the thing, but stand.
Jesus lifted high, the banner that flies across this land.
We're gonna sing. We're gonna see Jesus living high. Step by step, we're moving forward. Little by little, we take you there. Every day, a powerful weapon. Strongholds come tumbling down and down and down and down.
You wanna sing? You wanna sing? You wanna see Jesus living high? You wanna sing? You wanna sing? You wanna see Jesus living high?
We're gonna sing. We're gonna sing. We're gonna see Jesus lifted high. We're gonna sing. We're gonna sing. We're gonna see Jesus lifted high.
Brilliant. Well done. So we're going to come to our thinking about the Bible story now. So let's sit down and I'm just going to pray. So Father God, we thank you for this amazing true story from the Bible, and just speak to us now as we reflect on it. Amen. Well, I don't know if you've found times when things just haven't gone well and you're just getting a bit fed up, but then suddenly God steps in and does something amazing that you would just not have believed, and it wouldn't have happened unless things had actually apparently gone wrong in the first place. I remember my own experience back in 1987. I was about to start my first job in London, and I had to find somewhere to live. So I went down to stay with a friend in London for a few days, and if I still hadn't found a place to live after a few days, I would go on to a second friend in Tooting. Well, no joy at all. Couldn't find a place to live. So one day, after having looked in North London at some flats, they'd already gone, went to East London, they'd already gone. I was feeling miserable, and I had this big rucksack, and I went all the way down to Tooting. No mobile phones, of course, to contact people then. And I dragged my heavy rucksack up the steep hill and got to my friend's house in Tooting, and on the door it said, "Dear Peter, we're in central London in a pub. Come up and join us." Oh, I've just been in central London. So picked up my heavy rucksack thinking, I can't believe it. I've got to put this in the corner of a pub somewhere. Back down the hill, really, really feeling fed up. And on the train platform, I sat down and somebody shared the message of Jesus with me. And I was just very receptive. And I didn't become a Christian that night, but it was an important step on my journey to faith. And looking back, unless my friends had not been where they should have been, I would not have ended up on that platform meeting that person telling me about Jesus. And we see something like that in today's true story from the Bible. But I hope you're listening. So first of all, who are the main two characters we heard about? Paul and Silas. Now, I was hoping that we'd have a few more children. But Alfie, do you want to play the part of Paul and I'll play Silas? So come on out here. And there were a few more people with us. There was people like Luke and Timothy, but we're the main characters. And we like to go in the city of Philippi to the place of prayer. Now, the place of prayer is around there, and we like to go there every day. So come on, let's go. But there is a problem. I might have to pick on somebody. Who should I pick on? Every time we start going to the place of prayer, there's somebody a bit peculiar starts annoying us. It's a slave girl. Wait, do you want to be the slave girl? And this slave girl just kept following and being annoying. Go on, you can shout, "I'm very annoying." Yep, come on, annoy us, say, "I'm very annoying."
Annoying.
She's annoying. Well, let's go back. Let's see if she continues being annoying. Now, the problem is, this girl is possessed by an evil spirit, so she's not very happy at all. But one thing that the evil spirit lets her do is do fortune telling, tell the future. And the problem is, that earns a lot of money for her owners, who's very, very, very happy about making this money. So eventually, we get so fed up that, Paul, you're going to tell the evil spirit to come out of her in the name of Jesus. So say, "Out in the name of Jesus."
Out in the name of Jesus.
And suddenly, the evil spirit left her in the name of Jesus, and she's free. Say, "Yippee." Yeah, that's brilliant. Let's give Abby a round. You can sit down now. Well, Abby is absolutely happy. She's been set free of the evil spirit, but there's somebody who's not so happy. Because the owners can't make any money anymore. Because she's not telling people's fortunes. She's lost that gift. And the owner's looking, that's a mean face, isn't it? And he wants to get Paul and Silas thrown into prison. So he didn't say it quite clearly in the slapstick theatre, but he took us to the people in charge, the officials who threw us into prison and chained us up. Now this is where the prison doors were locked. And come on, we better be chained up here. So come on, we're chained up. Come on, sit down. Our feet are put in stocks as well. But the thing is, are we unhappy about this? We fed up? Can you remember the story?
No.
No. Believe it or not, we see this as an opportunity. We can tell more people about Jesus, all the fellow prisoners. So from our, they can't go anywhere. It's a captive congregation. So all night long, Paul and Silas are telling everyone the good news about Jesus and singing praises to God. Hallelujah. And then God does something amazing. Oh, I forgot to say, by the way, they even beat us up before they put us here. That was a bit nasty, wasn't it? Stripped our backs and flogged us. Anyway, here we are, but it doesn't matter because we've got an opportunity to tell people about Jesus. And then there's an earthquake. And what happens at the earthquake? The chains came off. And the doors flew open of the prison. But we decide not to escape. We stay here. And now, Gavin, would you mind being the jailer? The jailer came along and thought, oh no, I'm in trouble. I can see the open doors and chains. I'm in trouble. I'm going to be killed.
I'm in trouble. I'm going to be killed.
Don't worry. We're still here. We haven't run away. And with that, the jailer switched on the lights and was amazed. All the prisoners were still there, out of their chains. Can you remember what was said by the jailer? Anyone? What must I do to be saved? And Paul and Silas said, you've got to say, believe in Jesus. Can you say that?
Believe in Jesus.
Believe in Jesus and you'll be saved, you and your whole household. And the jailer was so happy, he takes us home, to his home, looks after our beat up, because we've been beat up. Oh, where's your home? So his home's over here. The jailer tended our wounds. He gave us a nice slap-up meal, and he and his whole family believed in Jesus and were saved and were baptized. And the next morning, the city officials realized they'd made a mistake. So come on, shall we go back to the front? And they called the jailer and said, let them go. And Paul and Silas said, hang on, don't they realize we're Roman citizens? We should never have been thrown in jail in the first place. And when the city officials heard about that, they said, sorry, you can go, please forgive us. And that's the story of today. So let's give them a round of applause. I just want to say three things about that thing. Can I just have the little clicker? There we go. See, that worked. Brilliant. So this is our today's Bible reading. And if you want to read it when you get back home, it really is a fascinating read. But the first thing we see is our God is powerful. And where do we see the power of God today? The slave girl, completely possessed by this evil spirit. But one word in the name of Jesus, and the spirit came out, and she was set free. There's the power of God. But I think that earthquake is amazing. It shook the prison, but what type of earthquake throws open all the prison doors and releases all the chains? The power of God. This is our God. He's on our side, and he is amazing. Our God is powerful. But secondly, not only is he just a powerful God, he cares. He cared about the slave girl. And he freed her. He cared about Paul and Silas. They were, they were beaten up, but the jailer tended their wounds. And then, of course, they were apologized to. Our God cares. Maybe you're going through a difficult period at the moment, but just know we have a God who cares for us. And even if we sometimes go through difficult periods, he will always make up for it tenfold. And of course, the biggest thing of all, our God saves. Our God saved the slave girl. He set her free. All those prisoners listening to the message of Jesus, some of them would have become Christians that night. They were fascinated by hearing the message. And of course, the jailer when he heard, he asked, how can I be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, his death and resurrection, and you will be saved, you and all your family. And he went home and they were all baptized. Our God saves. But do you notice that God used that bad situation of Paul and Silas going into prison to enable prisoners who had never ever heard about Jesus any other way to hear? The jailer would never have heard gone to prison. Our God saves. Maybe you've never been saved. Maybe you need to call on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and know his salvation. Finally, this powerful God who saves people, he is worthy to be praised, isn't he? Many of us know how good God has been to us. He is worthy to be praised. And I'm really, I can get fed up when things go wrong. But Paul and Silas, what did they do? They just kept praising God, knowing that he was doing amazing things, even when they were in prison. Our God is worthy to be praised. Let me say a prayer. I will just pray for us. If we've never met Jesus before, maybe just ask him to save you. And then we'll praise his name again. Father God, thank you that you are so powerful. Help us to remember that when things are going wrong, you're still there, working your mighty hand, because you care so deeply for us. Lord, help us, if we've never been saved, to come to you and to believe on your name and be saved. And help us to, like Paul and Silas, always look for opportunities to share the good news of Jesus so other people, like that jailer, can be saved. And help us just to praise your name, because you've done so much good to us. Amen. So we are going to sing our next song. Of course, Paul and Silas were praising God in the middle of the night. It's the daytime, but it is still a great day to praise the Lord. I think we know the actions for this, walking in the light of God. So follow me and we'll sing. Let's stand. Sit down, and just before Gavin comes to pray for us, you should all have received a cord as you came in this morning. Now, some of you will remember us doing this a few years ago for Thy Kingdom Come, and we're giving these cords out because our God is powerful and wants to save people, but he will only really save people if we're praying for them. And we do know, as we heard when Alex was baptized a couple of weeks ago, that when people pray for somebody, amazing things can happen. So just tie a knot in for somebody you want to pray for. To become a Christian or to go deeper with God. And maybe you could go up to 5 or maybe just 3 or even just leave it at 1. But just tie maybe a couple of knots for people that you want to pray for. And then each day, just run your finger along and each knot, remember the person that you should be praying for and just pray that they will come to know the Lord Jesus and his salvation, like that jailer did. And then you can go on to the second one. And you can bring your cords here every week, or you can just remember your people. But each week, we're just going to spend a little bit of the service just in silence, remembering all those people we're praying for. So you might not have thought of all your people yet, but maybe you just thought of at least one. Let's just have a moment of silence and just to ask that the Lord might bring that person to know Jesus. Our God is powerful and our God saves. We pray that he will save our friends. Amen. And Gavin's going to lead us in our intercessions.
Let us pray. Father God, we give you thanks as we enter a new month. We offer you now our prayers of intercession, praying that you will answer them according to your will and in your timing. We pray for peace around the world, for those areas facing war and conflict. We remember especially the situation in Ukraine and the Middle East. We pray for the peacemakers. We pray for hope for all those facing difficult situations. We pray for those who face daily oppression or persecution. We pray for those who are unwell, for those who continue to suffer from COVID, those suffering from other medical conditions, and those awaiting treatment. Bring your healing, we pray. We pray for those who mourn the loss of loved ones. Surround them with your love and your peace. We pray for families who are struggling as a result of rising utility and living costs, who are having to make challenging decisions at this moment. We pray for wisdom to be given for the decision makers so that they can make fair decisions that will benefit the most needy. We give thanks for the charities that work with those who are struggling in these challenging times. May they still receive the resources they need. We pray for those who bring hope to others. We pray to those who we love and care for. We pray for our own families, for the many different and individual situations we face. We ask you to intercede in these situations. We pray for our church family. We thank you for Peter and his family, for all the families that make up this community. May we in unity and in worship support and encourage one another through our faith, through our prayers, and for our love for one another. Help us to be more trustful, more hopeful, more faithful servants for you. All these prayers we ask in and through the name of Jesus, our Lord and Saviour. Amen. Let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you, Gavin. We're going to come to, I think, our final song of praise now. We haven't sung this for a bit, but again, it's following that theme that our God saves. And let's just remember that as we to go away with our cords and knots, to let our God saves. And when we pray for people, he will act and he will hear. Might take a while, but keep on praying. Tea and coffee will be served afterwards, but let's sing. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Spirit, Lord, we come. We're gathered together to lift up your name, to call on our Savior, to fall on your grace. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Spirit, Lord, we come. We're gathered together to lift up your name.
Father God, we thank you for all that's collected here in this collection plate, through the online ordering system and by standing orders. We just thank you for everything, and we give back to you, and we pray that you will increase your kingdom through our giving. Amen. And now may the God who saves, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, bless you and keep you. The Lord turn his face upon you and give you peace. Amen. Do enjoy a cup of tea.